Hi, and welcome back. We're going to start our predictive maintenance journey by taking a look at the first two steps of the workflow. So in the first step, we will use a Simulink model as a digital twin to generate synthetic failure data. And then in the second step, we will pre-process such data so that it's ready to be further processed as condition indicators. So let's jump into Simulink and let's take a look at the model that we have here. So here we have a plant that represents our flow pack machine, and then we have a controller. Also, we have a simple subsystem block that generates the reference position signal. Let's go deeper into the plant. And here we have a couple of subsystems. So we have a mechanical plant, and then we have an electrical plant that is driving the joint. So let's go deeper again. And what we can notice here, we have a few blocks that represent rigid bodies, and then we have some joints and rigid transform blocks. Let's go back now and let's examine the electrical plant. In this case, we have a servo motor, and this servo motor is driving one of the joints of the flowback machine. So now let's go higher in the hierarchy. And let's go back to the controller. So if we look under the mask of the controller, we have a couple of PIDs. So we have a cascade control loop here, we have a velocity control, and a position control algorithm. So what we want to do now, we just want to run the model and see what it looks like. We can see how the flowback machine should behave in normal operating condition. So all it does is pushing blocks and packets on a conveyor belt. We could pause the system, or maybe we can just again look at what's happening. But essentially the main point of this step of the predictive maintenance workflow is to reuse this model to generate failure data. But you know, first of all, we need to model the failures. So let's see how we model the failures in this case. What you can see here is a particular block. And in particular, this is a variable rotational damper block. We will use this block to model the degradation of the bearing system just by using a Simulink custom block to increase the value of the friction. If you go back now and we go to the electrical plant, we can see that here we are injecting faults on the gearbox. And the way that we do this is just by using custom block and reducing the efficiency of the gearbox itself. And here we have a slightly more complicated subsystem that will help us to model winding failure, which basically means breaking one of the phases of the servo motor. So one solution that we may have to generate data, in particular failure data, is to go into the mask of the subsystem and then modifying these values that we have seen before. So this might be a very simple way, but it might take a bit of time to generate a lot of data, which is what we need for predictive maintenance applications. So let's see how we can actually be a bit smarter about this. And let's go back here in MATLAB and let's open a live script. So what we will do with this live script is basically using MATLAB APIs to automate the process of generating failure data. So the first thing that we do here is activating the parallel pull. And this is very helpful in situations where we need to generate a lot of data through simulations. So in particular, we can leverage all the physical cores on our machine to speed up the process. So what we do here, we create simulation input objects. And in particular, what we're doing here, we are constructing all the possible combinations of faults that we might want to take a look at. And in particular here, we will simulate 2,652 different scenarios. So if we go on, We will use the generate simulation ensemble function, and we will collect all our data into a very useful structure that is called simulation ensemble data store. So as you can see here, we have run a lot of simulations in parallel by using four physical cores on this machine. So after we do this, we actually preprocess our data a little bit. And what we do, we first visualize the simulation ensemble data store. And as you can see, this is a very useful structure that we can use to point our data that we have generated in simulation. And this will make things much easier when we want to handle a large amount of data. So by taking a look at the pre-processing, we can actually see that what we do here is something very simple. You may want to do something more accurate than what I did here, but essentially what we do here is cutting the initial transient of our data. So we are calling a function which we called cutInitial. And what we do in this function, we just cut the initial t seconds and then retime the signals. So this is essentially what you could, for example, smooth your data or filter your data or do something else as required. And you know, once again, all the preprocessing is done in parallel through the cores on our machine. And this is the end of the first two steps of the workflow. So in the next video, we will see how we can actually extract features from the data. So stay tuned.